Hey, hi everyone. My name is Mandeep, and in today's video, we are going to discuss about a very important topic, which is named as exploratory data analysis, and it is also called as EDA in machine learning terminology. So, before jumping on to the coding part, I would just want to show you what is the generic process that we follow while creating a model and from starting collecting the data and till the model is deployed. So this is the model that we follow in our machine learning process. Majorly, we first do the data loading part. We get the raw data, and then we do the exploratory data analysis. This is the thing that we are going to cover in our today's video. Then we do feature engineering, then we create our model, then we train our model, then we test our model, and then finally, if we get our model right, and then we deploy it. If we do not get our model right, then we kind of come back onto the model creation part and kind of re-engineer ourselves. And we try different models and kind of hyper-tune our model so that it could give better predictive results. So this is the typical generic machine learning model process. It may vary according to the requirement, but these are the generic things that are being generally followed. So today I'm going to tell you what we generally do in exploratory data analysis. Exploratory data analysis, we try to explore the data and we understand lots of features, lots of things about data, how the features are correlated with each other, how many missing values are there. Lot of the analysis is done in this duration to identify what kind of feature engineering we would need. And I'm going to tell you a very super cool trick or a super cool library, which is very helpful in doing this thing only in 5 commands. So let's get started. So very first, I'm going to import pandas. If anyone who is watching this video and do not know about pandas, they can go back in my playlist, and I have created a video on pandas as well. So I would suggest them to take a look on that part, that video. So very first, I have imported pandas, and then I'm kind of reading a CSV file, which is on my local machine. And if I show it to you, this is my CSV file, which I have downloaded from Kaggle.com. Kaggle is again a very good platform for machine learning engineers, data scientists. People can find data sets over there and they can build model on that platform. They can learn. So lots of things are available on Kaggle.com. I will create a separate video for Kaggle, and just to keep stick to the purpose of this video. So I am showing you, this is the CSV file that I have downloaded. It has around 13,320 rows of data. So it's a huge data set. So this this file I have loaded into my data frame, which is this one. So now I have read my CSV file into data frame. Now we can perform exploratory data analysis on this data frame or this file as well. For that part, we need a library which is named as pandas profiling. It is very super cool library. You just can do your complete exploratory data analysis in one or two commands using this library. So for this, how we can install this library is with this command. If people who have not installed it, so this is the basically import sys is the module of Python. I'm importing that, and then I'm checking if this executable is not on my system, then just install it. Pip install pandas profiling, and these are the trusted hosts are given just to overcome the SSL certificate issue. Sometimes if you do not give these attributes with this command, it can give you exception and it can give you an error about the SSL trust issue. So now I have executed it. So it is showing me that already satisfied because I have already installed it. I just shown it to you so that I can tell you how we can install it. Now, after doing that part, we just can quickly take a look on our data set as well. As I told you in my previous video, df.head is used to take a look on the few of the data. Generally, it gives 5 rows of your data. So these are the 5 rows and these are the columns. You can see that 3, 6, and there are 9 columns. And so that means we have 9 features. And it is giving me only top 5 rows. So this is generally kind of basic check. Now we have our data frame in place. Now we can do the required part of it, which is our doing the exploratory data analysis. So only this command, before this command, I would like to import that library as well, which is panda profiling. Now I have imported it and I will imported it. And after importing, just run this command. So inside our pandas profiling, we have profile report, and this profile report will give you everything about your data analysis which you want. So how we can use it? Inside profile report, we can pass the data frame. We can give the title of the report that will be generated, and there is a flag for which we can give true or false, right? And now you are done. So it is kind of currently summarizing the data set. It will read it, then generate a report, and then I will take you through that report. See, this is the title, exploratory data analysis. Very first, it is showing me the overview of my data set, which is very pretty. And in this, you can see that these are the statistics. So there are 9 variables, or there were 9 columns. Out of 9 columns, 7 are of categorical type and 2 are of numeric type. And as it is showing as number of variable 9, number of observation are, that means how many number of rows are there, how many missing values are there, missing cells are there, 6,201, percentage, how many duplicate rows are there, what is the total size. So this is kind of overview, and it has given me few alerts as well about my data set. So you guys can see that it is showing me that availability has a high cardinality. 81 distinct value. So, and the similarly, location, society, total square feet are high cardinal features. Then that means they have a distinct value, a lot of distinct values. And now it is also showing me that bathroom and price, these two variables are highly correlated. Here it is showing me that high correlation. High correlation means these two variables are very tightly related with each other. That means a even a small significant change in one variable can change the value of other variable. Similar way, it is also showing the relation between other variables as well, respective variable. And it is also showing me that there is a feature which is named as society, and it has this much of missing values. So this is the overview of my data. And now if I scroll a little down, it will give me details about variable by variable. So very first it is showing me for area type, it has high correlation. It has four type of distinct values. These are the four type of distinct values: super built up area, float area, carpet area. So for super built up area, these much are values are there, 8790. Similarly, availability. Similarly, location. Similarly, size. How many values are distinct? How many are missing? These are my details about my variables. Now, after moving on to after variables, we can move on to the interactions. What interactions tells is that this shows kind of relationship between two variables. How two variables are kind of interacting with each other in data set. So here are the interaction between price and bathroom. Correlations, as I told you that there are four type of correlations generally, and sorry, there are five type of correlation which are kind of used, and behind each correlation there is some certain mathematical formula. In this video I do not want to go into those details. Few of the thing I'm just kind of just introducing new terms, and just to keep stick with the objective of this video. And objective of this video is to do exploratory data analysis quickly. So this is Pearson, Kendall. So, and you can also show the description of these. So these are a different type of Kendall also gave their theory that about correlation, how particular two variables are correlated. Then accordingly, Kramers and their Phil Spearman. So different type of correlations are there. If you want to explore more about these and their respective theorems or formulas, you can go to Google and check that part as well. Now, after that, moving on to the missing values. Now it is showing me that how many missing values are there. In area type, there are 13,320 values. So there is no missing value. Similarly, it is showing me feature wise how many values are. So in society, there are only 7,818 values. Rest of the values are missing. And this same thing is depicted in matrix form here, here heat map form, and here dendrogram. So this is just a different depiction of data, but it is communicating the same information to the user. And sample, it is showing me few rows from the data, just like we did with the head, and few starting rows, few last rows, duplicate rows. So that's all. And these are these are the things that we do in our exploratory data analysis. It is very easy, super handy. You can do it in just two commands and your exploratory data analysis is done. There are few terms which are introduced in my video, which are quite new. And I just kind of quickly discuss them. Maybe I will discuss more on those terms in my later videos. So that's all for today's video. Guys, just try this out. This is a super cool library and you will love it. And that's all for now. Please like, subscribe and comment on my channel. If you want some particular topic related videos, I'm working on machine learning and data science related videos. I'll be happy to help you. So till then, thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.